to another episode of the Arlington Experience with Jim Ross. I'm Jim Ross. I'm with Mark Jokel here at Create Arlington. I'm ashamed to say that when I came down here to talk to you, it's the first time I walked into Create Arlington.
Yep.
And I was floored.
Oh, great.
By the quality of artwork that you have here. And you were telling me that the artists here are all Arlington artists.
Yes, yeah.
And how did you get into this? How did you decide this is what we need to do here
sure.
in Arlington?
Well, about 7 years ago, I started a group called Arlington, Texas, Proud to Call It Home. And when I moved back here from New Orleans, it's kind of interesting. I heard like people bashing Arlington about certain things, you know, and I was like, whoa, you know, because, you know, I moved back here. And of course, what Arlington has to offer is so crazy, especially from the context of working and living in the inner city in New Orleans, you know, like I was working with schools there. There are problems. We're not having functioning restrooms, you know, and I came back here and I heard people talking bad about our schools. My kids, all I raised them here in Arlington and they went to, you know, Hill, Bailey and Arlington High. And so what I started doing is started a social media presence and started talking about all the positive things in Arlington. And with a real focus on gathering together people who are had cultural arts background, because we had a lot of arts things going on that a lot of people didn't know about either. And so it just snowballed from that. We had a group of artists. We started out of Park Plaza. We did like 26 murals out there. And and it just kind of grew very organically from there of gathering together artists, musicians. And then that rolled into the East Main Street Festival. And so it's just really through natural growth of relationships with artists. Then about 4 years ago, we put together a co-working plan and studio space, and I wasn't able to do that because it would have been a full-time job. And so here we are now. I was general manager at Arlington Music Hall, and my son worked for me. And March 13th, I canceled the first of 3 months of cancellation. So I canceled myself out of a job. So me and my son literally overnight lost our income.
Wow.
And so we had to, you know, repurpose what we were doing. He's a 21-year-old senior at UTA. And pulled out all the old designs of what we were working on at Park Plaza and, you know, put together what we felt like was a viable business plan to launch a co-working creative space. And so here we are.
And now tell me what it is Create Arlington does.
Sure.
What do you provide the community here?
Well, it's a membership-based business model. So people, when they become members, have different levels depending on what level that they join on a membership. But what we provide is a place to help people launch a new business. Not everybody coming in, college students aren't to that point yet that are members here, but our goal is to walk alongside people to help them put together business plans, vision statement, mission statement, everything, like I was mentioning, and we help people even make business cards from the bottom end. But it's a 24/7 facility. We're sitting in the middle of the gallery space. So all the art up here is art of members. So that's a huge benefit for our members is they have a gallery showing and it's a great place to meet prospects.
You started this business, this concept in the middle of the pandemic.
We could have waited.
Sure.
There's no doubt we could have waited. But at the same time, the investor was on board. You know, we are ready to step forward. And for me, I've got to be doing something, you know, and that just literally, you know, I went from working 60, 70 hours a week running Arlington Music Hall to idle. And so this has been great for me and my son to work together on. And so we went ahead and launched, and we've been pleasantly surprised by gathering people together. But you saw the space, and it's socially distanced. All our desks are separated, so people can come in and work in here, and people aren't falling all over each other. And
now you do more than just provide space for the artist.
Mm-hmm.
You also have gallery space mm-hmm. where people can present their concepts, like the chess pieces
right.
that are here, like the paintings that we see on
sure.
the wall. But you also provide space for other artists.
Sure.
You like a speakeasy type thing.
Right.
You'll let people come in and do different things.
Sure.
What else do you offer here?
Well, we have a third Thursday event we do outside every month. And that's really a way, once again, to put local artists in position to sell their art. Because that's the end game of all of this. You'll notice everything is priced. So we want to always make sure that artists have a place to sell their art. and display their art. And so once a month we do a third Thursday, and another membership benefit is you don't pay a booth fee for that. That becomes an event monthly. And then May the 8th, we have the West Main Street Festival, which members here don't have to pay for a booth for that. And last time we did the East Main Street Festival, it's now the West Main, we had about 7,000 people attend that. It's an all-day long event. So we're constantly doing things with the intent of getting our artists in front of prospective buyers.
That's incredible. If our viewers want to find you, how can they get sure. to you here on West Main Street?
Well, we're at 306 West Main. We actually have 304, 306, 308. Our official Google address is 306 West Main Street. And we're open Monday through Friday. The gallery and our space is open from 9 to 6 Monday through Friday and noon to 4 on Saturday, so people can come view the art, look at the art, meet our artists. People love coming in and talk to the artists as they're creating in the studio space. So social distance wise, you know, people can walk through and like come to any of our events. We had last night, we had a spoken word event here. Sunday, we're doing a live stream for Artemis Funk and two other local bands. So, man, we're open to rental of this space, use of this space. But most importantly, we want to be a cultural gathering center for people to come and learn.
Man, let me tell you, congratulations on an incredible concept. Most importantly, though, thank you for everything you're doing for the Arlington community, these Arlington artists who are taking advantage of what you offer here, for you reaching out and helping these young entrepreneurs to do stuff. It is people like you that make this community the American Dream City. Let me tell y'all something. Don't do what I did. Get here as soon as you can. You are going to miss one of the best hidden treasures in Arlington. Come support not just Create Arlington, but all of these individual artists that work and thrive out of this office here. Come over here. I promise you, you will be blessed like there is no tomorrow. God bless you. We'll see y'all on the next episode of the Arlington Experience with Jim Ross.